Before we begin, make sure to smash that like button, subscribe to our channel, and click the notification bell for more amazing videos.
Husband vanishes. 70 years later, wife gets call. She was now gravely worried. Maybe he'd fallen sick while on his way back from his deployment in Europe. It had been many weeks since she'd heard from him. After many years passed, she was still looking for him. But the day she heard the man's voice, she felt a tug at her heartstrings. The journey for the truth would lead the French woman on a long, hard road. Peggy Seale got straight A's and graduated just as the world was thrown into the chaos of World War II. She couldn't help all the men around her as they were forced to go fight abroad. She decided that she would go work at Altus Force Base in Oklahoma. That's where she met him, Billy. So Peggy went on a journey to Oklahoma from the town where she was raised in Vernon, Texas. She wanted to do her part, but she had no idea she'd find the love of her life. She soon found that she was the only mechanic at the Air Force Base. This meant she got a lot of attention from the others. One general gave her one look and set her up with his son, Billy. Peggy first tried to let Billy down easy the first time he wrote a letter. But then she bumped into him in a hangar at Altus Air Force Base, and it was love at first sight. They had only been married for a few weeks before Billy was called to duty and would be in the thick of war. He would be deployed in France fighting back against the Nazis. But she had no idea her goodbye would be the last time she'd look into his eyes. Peggy had to hide where her husband was. He was performing secret missions in Europe while she worried about him at home. After achieving great success, he'd be able to come home, but with all the injured soldiers, there was just no space for him. He wrote a letter detailing his delay, but he'd never make it home. Peggy nervously waited for months to get a letter from her husband. One day, she got a letter from the Supreme Headquarters Allied Expeditionary Force stating that he had already made it home. But as the days grew long and into weeks, Peggy had a bad feeling. She knew something had happened to him after he made it back, but where was he? Both Peggy and Billy's father went to the Red Cross, but they told them he was being processed. Surely that wasn't possible. Then they got another letter, simply stating that Billy was MIA, or missing in action. But it had been dated since July 7th. Something was wrong. You see, Peggy's last letter from Billy was dated after July 7th. Something was very wrong. She still didn't give up hope and looked out for him for many years. Now an old widow, Peggy just wanted closure. One day, she decided to call Billy's cousin to see if he could help her get one more good search. They would look far and wide with the available modern-day technology. Peggy wouldn't get her hopes up that he was alive. She just wanted the truth. After finding out what happened to him, she could finally move on with her life. She decided to call all the local cemeteries to check for his name. They eventually got a match, but it didn't end there. The cemetery asked to look over something and call them back, but when Peggy did, Peggy made a shocking discovery. The cemetery told Peggy that a French woman from Leventis already called them to request a pay for a copy of Billy's records. Her heart dropped. Who was this woman? What should have taken the cemetery about 6 months to gather together now could happen within days because Billy's record had already been recently pulled. The information was a match, and this time what was written beside his name was KIA, meaning killed in action. But who was this mysterious French woman? The French woman who pulled Billy's records turns out to be the mayor of the French village Leventz, a place where Billy Harris's name was well known. When Peggy contacted the mayor, she was delighted to hear from her and invited her to participate in one of their annual parades. Confused, Peggy asked why. What she said left her speechless. Not only was Billy Harris well known in the village, but he was also considered a town hero with a street named after him. Place Billy D. Harris. Peggy's eyes began to well as she was told what happened on that fateful day 7 decades ago. Peggy listened as she began to tell the incredible and tragic story of his heroism. During the war, Billy Harris saved countless lives, including the whole village of Leventz. You see, Leventz was under Nazi occupation. It was also where Billy Harris's plane got shot in combat. But as his plane was falling, he had two options: to save himself and eject from the plane, leaving it to crash into the town square, killing hundreds, or to divert the plane. Billy chose the latter and crashed into a nearby forest. Once villagers realized what he did, they rushed to his aid, but by the time they reached him, it was too late. Finally, Peggy has the closure she always desired and received a formal apology from the military for the discrepancy in accounting for Billy Harris's heroic departure from this world. Please share this with your friends and family.